throwbacks in today's Best R&B. It's live 104.9. It's just about 14 minutes before 9 o'clock. You got your home team morning show on the radio. So thanks a lot for starting your Tuesday morning with us. Tony Woods, Michelle Knight, Zach Locke.
Hey. Good morning. Hey, what's up? Everybody up? Everybody alive?
I need some more coffee.
You good, Michelle? Yes, I'm full of the coffee.
We got to get Dustin. We got to send Dustin on a run.
Yes.
Yes, we got to do that. Okay, now this is the topic I've been waiting on all morning. We're going to find out what's going on with Aaron Hernandez.
You already know I got a full glass of tea.
Okay.
So I've been following the case, and you know they laid him to rest on Monday. Uh-huh. So it's a really sad day. He was surrounded by his families and friends. But here's the real tea. Everybody is still cutting up for them gay lover photo prison letter things. Y'all heard about that, Michelle?
Yes.
Apparently, when he died, there was three letters next to his Bible, and one of them was to the prison lover human person. And so some people are going back and forth like, oh, you know, I don't really believe that. Maybe they're just talking about that for the drama. But I think it's true.
Oh, yeah.
I think
it's true.
I spent a lot of time around prisons. That sounds weird. Hold on. I had locked up.
Right.
In prison, and they would tell me the real tea and the real deal that goes on in there. Yeah. And so a lot of people that are married, and I'm not saying everybody that does it, so if you're at home listening and you got somebody in prison, they're not automatically going to be having a prison lover. But
it's very possible.
It's very possible.
Percentage up into, what would you say, on a scale of 1 to 100, what's the percentage that they probably are?
80%. Mm. So it depends on how long you're locked up.
That's what it depends on.
Yeah. Yes. And so they're still kind of debating about that. But you know me, I had to see what the dude looked like. So I Googled the image.
No, you got a picture.
I got a picture.
What
and
it
look
like?
It's very meth meets sulfur. Okay. He looks a little rough around the edges. I'm not going to lie. He definitely has a lot of hardcore tattoos. He got one on his face. Look like he stabbed somebody.
I got to look at this.
Look.
And it's up on KZWAFM.com.
Yeah, it's definitely. Go to our homepage to find
it. Sulfur meets meth.
Yeah, sulfur meets. It's very Poche town. So for people that are local that lives here, they know exactly what I'm talking about. And if you are from Poche town, well, there's that.
I got to ask. Yeah. Oh, you said that they spilled the beans on the tea since you spent so much time around these jails.
Yeah.
And they told you the role. Can you just give us an example?
Well, I would go there, right, for visitation, and you would see everybody on the Sundays with their families and stuff. Mm-hmm. And so one of my friends, who we're not going to mention his name, he would point out, hey, you see that guy with his two kids and three kids?
Right.
Let me tell you what he did last night.
Oh. Right.
Yeah. And so one time, it was super weird because you see all these people and their families, and I dropped something on the floor, and I got up to pick it up. He's like, no. And I was like, what? He was like, don't bend over. They wait for things like that. And I was like,
in the waiting room?
No, this was in visitation. I had on like jeans.
But
and
you
stuff.
Said they wait for things like that.
Yeah, they wait to be like
the prisoners or the guards.
The prisoners.
They can't do anything. Having, aren't they being restrained?
Yeah, well, but when you're a prisoner, imagination could go a long way.
You use your mind, Michelle.
Exactly.
I don't think Zach minds.
Let me tell you, when you've been locked up, I mean, okay, let's put this out there. I believe I'm the only one on the staff that's been in jail. I believe. Is that true?
Yes. Not it.
Okay. We've got one more in the back.
In a male prison,
It's a short time. It's a short time. But for my, 14 days or however long it was.
14.
No, after you're in there for a while, you change how you think.
Right. So how did your thinking change?
I had built up enough.
No, if you're going to start, you got to finish.
No,
you
I'm
gotta
just saying,
pouring
no,
the
I'm
pot,
just saying I agree with Zach. You're going to, and I said this yesterday, you're going to do things in prison that you wouldn't
but
do if you were a
But we
want
to know what
man.
You did.
I wasn't in jail long enough.
Well, and I wasn't
there long enough.
To come to Tony's defense.
Right.
14 days is not enough
that's
to start
enough
jumping fences and jumping on the other side.
But now, if you get life or 20 years and there's no females around,
I'm touching something.
You're going to have to just get next to
something.
The next best thing.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? And so I believe that. I haven't got to that point. I never got to that point.
And it's the same that goes with female prisons, too.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah. And that happens a whole lot more.
Oh, yes.
Somebody kind of broke that down to me.
And they do weird things. They find any object.
Whatever.
Works. Water bottle, hey, don't throw that away. Guess what I'm doing with it later.
I know, have you seen...
So did you spend a lot of time around female prisons, too?
God, no.
Can you get me a pass to get in one?
Yes, I got an all-access pass to the female prison.
They would love a brother like me.
I used to have a neighbor, and she spent some time in a female prison, 8 years.
That's a little bit more than some time.
But she said that that was not her thing, but it was women and that they really believed that they were married. They were in those relationships. They were serious. And I've watched some of those specials that they do. I believe it's like on the A&E Network or something like that. Well, that's a scripted series, but
well, the lead character really is in real life.
It's several of the women on that show that in real life, but they're not in prison in real life.
Okay, so
now we're talking about the prison mentality. Well,
like they do.
Here's the conversation we had yesterday, Zach. Okay, we've seen sulfur meth guy. Okay, so now, do you think he had relationships before he went to prison with men?
Yeah.
Probably so, you think?
A little bit. It's a crazy world. There's a lot of people that are not okay with themselves, and a lot of people on the DL. And so I don't have 100% proof. I didn't see them in the act.
Right.
But on a scale of 1 to 100, what's that percentage that it falls in where you think that he might have had a lover of another persuasion?
77.8.
Right. And then when he went to prison, well, I can say he probably was curious as a free man. But then when he went to prison,
he was like, "Oh, it's going down now.
It's got to go down now. I don't have a choice."
He dove in like it was a fresh.
Or maybe
box
he
of
felt like he
crunch.
Could finally be himself. Right. Maybe you never know.
I do believe if Aaron Hernandez, as a free man, walks into a club, he's looking at females. Now he might look at a guy. I don't think he's going to pursue it. But then once you go to jail, there are no females, so you got to just fall back.
Well, we'll never know at this point. No, but that was the whole reason they said that they thought that that's why he started killing people, because the secret was going to come out.
And that's the crazy part.
I don't believe that.
I had a friend that was like super dudish, da-da-da-da-da, and he was always so mad. And then one day he was like, "Hey, bro, I like dudes." And I was like, that explains everything.
Was he a happier person after that?
Oh, yeah. He was just running around. I can't say what I was about to say, but
live true to yourself. Be you.
Be you. Be you.
Yes, that's
or be clear.
Be clear.
Be happy about being clear. Claim it, Tony. Yeah. Own it.
And no matter what you do, be safe. Don't be spreading all that nasty gri-gri all over the place. Do you know what gri-gri is?
I don't want to know.
You shouldn't.
Mm-mm.
On a Tuesday.
Oh, skeet.
Again, if you haven't seen the dude, you can check out his picture. Aaron Hernandez's possible lover, or ex-lover now, because he has expired. KZWAFM.com.
Okay, we'll get the stories pretty soon that somebody has seen Aaron Hernandez and Tupac and Biggie in the Bahamas. That's coming up. No doubt about that. Since we're speaking of prison love, I thought this song would be appropriate. It's the Book of Love on Live 104.9. Good morning.